Okay, one last thing to pop in before we get right into the criticism. Hit it, Craig! Contra Core isn't even good enough to be shit. It might not be the absolute worst game I've ever played, but it might very well be the most pathetic. Contra Rogue Core is pitiful. It's an embarrassment. This is embarrassing even for Konami. Just having your name in the credits of this pathetic wretch in software form should be grounds for industrial humiliation. You should be ashamed of yourself if your name is attached to this pile of cold cum. And what's striking about this game is just how antithetical to Contra it is. Now, if you're unfamiliar with Contra, don't worry, the fuckers who made this game aren't familiar with it either. But there is one thing you ought to know. Even if you've only had a passing interest in Contra, even if you've only ever just seen a bit of it played, you know it's a game about shooting incessantly. A constant hail of bullets as monsters descend on you with merciless abandon. Not so in this game. The village idiots who cobbled this nonsense together saw the shooting in Contra and thought, "Now that's the least popular bit. There's a cooldown meter on your guns. They overheat if you fire them for too long." Sorry, if saying too long makes the guns sound way more generous than they are. That makes it sound like you actually do have to fire your gun for a long time before it overheats. Nope. You can barely keep the trigger held for a few seconds on some of these weapons before you find yourself unable to shoot. Even if you upgrade weapons as you go along and waste precious upgrade space, improving the overheating system on your weaponry, you're still forced to stop and start your fire rate. If you don't want the gun to overheat and become completely inoperable for 5 very long seconds, you have to fire and then not fire and then fire and then not fire to keep that cooldown meter regulated. All while being paradoxically encouraged to keep firing because there are so many enemies swarming you. And just to keep things extra spicy, there's a slight lag on the overheating meter. So if you think you've got it right on the edge of just being about to overheat and then stop firing, it might overheat anyway. You're allowed to bring 2 guns with you, and maybe, if I'm being generous, this utterly otherwise pointless overheating system may be in place to encourage you to switch to your sub-weapon. But it's a sub-weapon. Sub being the operative word, not like that. What if you brought with you a chainsaw as a sub-weapon, or an acid sprayer as a sub-weapon, something that doesn't have range, but the enemies are all out of range? Well, enjoy sitting there, doing nothing, while your main gun cools down. Cools down! This is Contra! And you're waiting, doing nothing, because your gun overheated! In Contra! Your gun overheated! You can't fire your gun in Contra! You can't keep shooting in Contra anymore! It's Contra, and you can't shoot your gun! You can't shoot a gun in Contra! The sheer idea of cooldown meters and overheating guns being in Contra is funny, but in practice, it's far from humorous. It's not just that the overheating system is there, it's that it's a bad overheating system. It's too stingy, it's too harsh a cooldown meter, and it's too laggy to even adequately monitor while you play. It's like they had the worst idea they could have for Contra, and then they did it in the worst way possible. And that's just the tip of the wankberg, friends. This game overall is cheap, nasty, ugly as sin, repetitive, full of recycled content, the same bosses over and over and over again. Even within the first few missions, it starts reusing levels over and over. The boss you just fought in one level will then appear ad nauseam in the very next. Look forward to seeing the big round guy with an anteater gas mask over and over again. I started laughing every time I saw him, because I was like, the first time I saw him, he was a boss. Now he's everywhere. And even though he's everywhere, he still manages to be the boss of most of the levels. Every now and then you will come across something a bit different in boss form, like at the end of a long series of missions. But they take such a long fucking time to beat. Their health meters are huge and you chip away at it, like going at a tree trunk with a spoon. And they're not hard. That's the other thing. None of this game is hard. Once you start fighting a boss, or really, once you start doing anything in this game, it just does the same stuff over and over again, really slowly. So you fall into this pattern, this cycle of doing the same shit over and over in a sluggish way for ages, to the point where the only challenge in Rogue Core is to try and stay awake while you play it. I also can't emphasize enough how horrible this feels to play and control. Your character is slow. They slow down even more when they shoot, so you can't even effectively run and gun in this so-called Contra game. You get a dash, which is actually really powerful. It knocks enemies all over the place and can outright kill some of them. It's also needed to knock unconscious various metal enemies that your guns don't really work. That your guns aren't effective fighting! There are enemies that make your guns ineffective in the Contra game, folks. But anyway, as powerful as the dash is, it still feels shit to use. There's a sluggishness to it. It's stilted, your character lags after you use it, you can't fire up, or if you can, the game never told me how. But at least there's not, like, you know, flying enemies or anything, except when there are. You can't even fire up an incline. If you're going up some stairs or a hill, your character will just shoot into the floor or the steps as they go up. That's even if you use the game's overzealous aim assist feature, which you can turn off, but if you do turn it off, bear in mind that when the camera wrests your vision away from you and you're firing at things you can't see, you'll have a harder time hitting them. Because the camera controls itself and will shift around depending on your location on the map. Which, of course, is fucking atrocious. Because if you're moving to get away from enemies and you move to where the camera starts shifting around, you will just have all that harder a time knowing where you are, where your enemies are, or anything. Anything! One thing you don't know about this game is what made them think any of it was okay. It presents one of my hardest challenges as a critic, because I can't decide whether this piece of trash is the result of laziness or sheer fucking incompetence, or good old-fashioned cheapness. Probably all three. No money, no effort, no talent. You can't pause the game even in single player, which is what you'll probably be playing it in, because I tried to play online. There's even PvP. I can't tell you what it's like. No one's fucking playing this. No one should be playing this. But yeah, that was an unpleasant surprise when I had to pause the game to do something and then found out that I was being killed. It's got shoddy visuals, lackluster sound effects, barely any noticeable music. It feels so soulless, heartless. Hell, it feels artless. It's a game that feels as if it was made with absolutely no pride. It feels like it was made with absolutely no shame. I don't think you could deliberately design a game so antithetical to Contra, so unlike what people expect from the series, while also being so insultingly inefficient, inept, and subpar in every single department. From the aesthetic to the controls to the combat system, no one single element of Contra Rogue Core even reaches the lofty goal of basic acceptability. Contra Rogue Core aspires to mediocrity and never makes it that far. Oh, I just saw an interview with one of this game's developers. Sorry, not developers. One of this game's culprits, Nobuya Nakazato, who said aiming up is a feature of weapon customization with certain weapons that you fire straight up in the air with. Oh. Fuck this game. I realise this video has gone into a full-on rant, but no amount of words, no amount of fury in my voice can describe the crushingly underwhelming disappointment one consistently feels while playing. There is not one single tiny portion of this game that feels right, that is right. It's all wrong. Not just as a Contra game. Hell, I don't even have that deep an attachment to Contra. It's just a game that's there to me. Even as a basic stick shooter, as a basic arcade-style shooter, it's slow. It's wrong. It's bad. It's a bad game. It's not a good game. It is a bad time to play for you to have. It's a sad game to have bad times with. You have bad time for game now, play, please. It's no good, no goody game. No goody game. Why can't you run and gun? Why do you move so slow? Why are the special attacks so quiet? Why do you need to constantly dash to fight enemies that can't be shot properly? And why, if the dash is so important, does it feel so miserable to use? Why does the game intermittently switch to shooting gallery mode for a few moments at a time, when doing so makes the already terrible controls feel that much worse? Why do the guns overheat if you use them for a matter of seconds? Why are the same enemies and the same levels used over and over again? Why does the game recycle itself within a few missions? Why are there fucking dreadful platform sections? Why can't Konami publish a good fucking game? And why? Why in the triangular earth does Contra Rogue Core have a fucking season pass?
A goddamn fucking season pass? Season pass?
How embarrassing. I muttered that to myself pretty regularly while playing. A bit like Jay Bauman from Red Letter Media, I just went, how embarrassing. Because it is embarrassing. I said earlier, even by Konami's standards, it's embarrassing. The Metal Gear Survive publisher should consider this an embarrassment. I mean, to my knowledge, this is the biggest non-football game that Konami has squirted out of its milky red raw anus since Metal Gear Survive. Just fucking shocking. Shockingly poor. Appallingly bad. Humiliatingly awful. Clumsy, amateurish bollocks. A game that doesn't even manage to shit all over the Contra series because it's too busy shitting all over itself. But you can play as a panda in it, so 10 out of 10, I guess.